Hello people, I'm Stagmaster 15, getting my feet wet and trying out something new and going for a commentary for the hell of it. Now, I'm gonna be somewhat sly here, so I just ask that you meet me halfway here. This is my first commentary after all. I also happen to have a painfully embarrassing speech impediment, so if you hear something pronounced rudely, well, that. And while this video doesn't give me too much as far as what I'm going to say goes, it's a bit of a disclaimer for the future. I will whiff moments here and there. I will sound like an asshole at some point. I'm not really going to control myself. If this bothers you, fuck off, because I'm not here to cover for your sensibilities. Now, Skulls, who will be referred to as Skulls because this username is just way too fucking hard to pronounce, is basically a dumb PokeTuber. If you've seen enough commentaries covering Pokemon, that's really all you need to know. I will say, however, that he's different from most other PokeTubers in one way. But we'll figure out that one way as the video goes on. The video of his I'll be covering is his top 10 best dark type Pokemon list. I'm not gonna claim to be some Pokemon expert. In fact, I've actually never played any of the Pokemon games besides Pokemon Go. But I've had a huge interest in the series for years, so much of what I'm gonna say is gonna be based off research. But once we start dissecting the video, you might notice I might not need gaming experience to critique these points.
Go over some rules for what qualifies on this list. The first rule is that these are only pure dark type Pokemon. No dual types allowed, like Weavile, and no Pokemon are allowed that can change their type to dark or can change their type away from dark, like Arceus. The best dark type Pokemon have to be those that are strong enough to hold their own in a Pokemon battle while also being able to support their allies during a competitive double battle.
Now, if you don't mind, I'm gonna go through these rules backwards. Now, I don't really have a problem with the third rule since it's somewhat reasonable, but I'm telling you guys now, it's not gonna matter too much into this list anyway. For the second rule, I don't mind you not accepting mons that change to dark, but why does changing from dark disqualify it? But I won't look too deeply into that either because, again, it's not gonna matter too much into this list. But with this first rule, I just have to ask, why only pure dark types? There can't be something wrong with including dual types into the list. You definitely give no reason why they have to be pure dark to qualify for a dark type Pokemon list. So all I can do is theorize. Are there some special advantages to dual types that pure dark types don't have? Because I'm not too sure about that. If you look at the mons through a variety of aspects like their stats, their coverages, their strengths and weaknesses, their lore, etc., you can make good arguments to why one mon would be better than another. And while one can argue the issue of overlapping mons, since he will most likely talk about other types, I will have to counter argue and say, why not focus on mons that have dark as the primary typing? They do exist. But that's only scratching the surface of why this is a bad choice. Now, as someone who has been really interested in Pokemon, one of the things I like to study is the type balances. Thanks to a certain site that is able to tell me how the mons are able to defend themselves against attacks of a specific type, not only do I get to study said type balances, it tells me the mons that belong to the categorized type. Now, knowing that, let's take a look at, just at how many mons there are in the pure dark category. Exactly 10. And while this number doesn't seem bad at face value, there are some things that need to be taken into account with this number. This number does not account for evolutions, counts a mega evolution as a single mon, and it happens to include a legendary. I don't see this going well right now.
Number 10 is Poochyena. The first Pokemon you encounter during your journey in Hoenn is always this sucker. And as many a shiny hunter knows, this is the most common failed shiny Pokemon as well.
Oh. A shiny. Are you kidding me? Really? What?
Number 9.
Question mark? I didn't edit that damn thing in there. He tells us Poochyena is the first mon we encounter in the Hoenn region, says it's a failed shiny to the shiny hunters, plays a clip of some dude upset that he found said shiny number 9. Now I couldn't care less why a shiny Poochyena is a bad thing, but I have a good question. But let's hear his number 9 first.
Number 9, Purloin. A dark type cat Pokemon can only mean sinister things are afoot. Purloin are often sneaky and manipulative, and usually get exactly what they want. While it has the lowest attack stat of all Dark-type Pokémon, it still finds uses in other areas. In the anime, it is shown to take advantage of several other Pokémon and even some humans, even going to great lengths for something as simple as obtaining a berry. It may not look like much, but whenever you see a purloin, you might want to double-check your step. It's a sneaky one.
Okay, now I have a couple of questions. First, why bring up stuff from the anime? Is it important? Can I also know how he mentions that Pauline has the lowest attack set out of all the dark types in the games, and then points at how it has other uses that only apply to the anime? And these extremely brief explanations on Puccina and Pauline just beg the question, why exactly is Pauline better than Puccina? The only one explanation I can cook up is that this guy is a cat person. Pauline happens to have better overall stats than Puccina. Is that why it's better? If so, why didn't you fucking tell me that? In fact, are we gonna factor in how they are in-game at all anymore? Well, fuck.
Number 8, Zorua. Don't let this adorable fox fool you. It's a cunning, manipulative little thing. It can even manipulate its own appearance to look like another Pokémon. And as the TV show has shown us, it can even appear as a human if it so chooses. Zorua may not be the most competitive Pokémon out there, but it still holds its own in battle. Imagine the terror that goes through its enemies' minds when they see a Mewtwo or a Rayquaza hit the battlefield, never suspecting that it's really just a small fox Pokémon in disguise. Zorua is definitely not one to be underestimated.
Yeah, that would definitely be troubling. Until you realize that it would change into Mewtwo or Rayquaza if either one of them won the last spot of your party. Zorua's illusion ability only changes it to the monsters in the last spot of your party, and the ability Plague to feast directly hit. On top of that, it seems to be purely aesthetic, so it doesn't really do much for it. Zora's uses in battle seem somewhat situational, but at least it's got better stats than the other two. Wait, am I sensing a pattern? I am literally going to spill you the whole Absol segment because it's literally just trivia filler. I mean, I know Absol is most definitely going to be better than the previous choices considering those choices were plea evolutions, but could you not be bothered to put something of substance into this segment? He doesn't even talk about Absol's abilities in battle whatsoever or why it doesn't beat out any other mon in the list. Somewhat.
And our number 6 spot is Liepard. This Pokémon looks almost too graceful to be a Dark-type Pokémon, but like its pre-evolved form, Liepard is a conniving, manipulative feline. Its most useful moves, including Knock Off and Sucker Punch, are the best examples of Dark-type moves out there. Crafty and subtle, Liepard can deal some serious damage. Or, if it's feeling especially pesky, it will just encore you into using the same move over and over and over again. Give it some black glasses to boost those Dark-type moves even more.
First, I love how you acknowledge the plea evolution, as if you couldn't fit your explanation on Pauline into the Liepard segment, which really throws Pauline segment into question. In other news, he finally starts bringing up points from the game, and they aren't great. For starters, you mentioned Knock Off and Sucker Punch being two of the best Dark-type moves out there, so I'm not to presume that they're good for Liepard, which would be fine advice if you're playing Omega Ruby, Alpha Sapphire, Black 2, and White 2. Now, Liepard does learn Sucker Punch naturally at level 55 in all the games that it's in, but the only way that it learns Knock Off is through tutoring in the two games I just mentioned. But here's a fun fact for you. Do you know who happens to learn Sucker Punch naturally by level right now but a sooner level, and has a better attack stat than Liepard? Absol. I can't even give you the base stat in Gliscag anymore, god damn it! Also, why would someone use Encore for a Liepard? Wouldn't someone just go for a move that it's weak to? Why would you want someone using that move over and over again? And couldn't that Black Glasses item point work in Absol's favor over Liepard since Absol has a better attack stat? Oh, but Absol would already be holding something already.
Never mind.
Number 5 on this list is Mightyena. There is just one word that best fits this Pokémon. Crunch. A crunch from a Mightyena hits hard. Just look at it! This Pokémon has Crunch written all over its face! And where Crunch fails, just use a Play Rough or Iron Tail to hit everything else. Mightyena just can't be stopped!
Alright, so I don't have a lot to say about the Crunch portion of the list due to the fact that only pure Dark type to a lot on the list, and none of them can learn Crunch at all other than Poochie. On that note, I'm gonna have to question the whole point of the Poochie in this segment as well. It didn't have much to begin with, but still. Also, take what I said about Lightbulb wanting knockoff and switch with Mighty Ena wanting Iron Tail. The only real difference is Mighty Ena could at least learn Iron Tail through TMs in Gens 3 and 4. Which is funny when you consider Mighty Ena doesn't even get Clunch in Gen 4 or in Black and White unless Poochyena learned the move first. And when does Poochyena learn Clunch? Level 53. And keep in mind, Poochyena evolves at level 18. GG. Now I'm gonna skip the whole Umbreon segment because there's not much I can talk about.
Number 3 is Zoroark. The illusion Pokémon has been popular ever since it was first introduced to the Pokémon world. It's a tricky Pokémon. Literally. Its ability allows for it to gain the appearance of any Pokémon you want while still retaining its original typing and moveset. Using Zoroark in battle can take some getting used to, but it's still a whole lot of fun. Send it out looking like a random Poison-type Pokémon and your opponent will be caught off guard when Psychic doesn't affect it.
So, for the number 3 segment, you give an extremely brief summary on Zoroark being popular, call it tricky, and explain his ability. Not only does this give particularly no justification why Zoroark is this high at all, but you can literally apply this segment to Zora. It's fucking pre-evolution! Nope, moving on, fuck this segment.
Number 2, Mega Absol. We have to bend the rules here, because if we counted Mega Absol as just an extension of Absol, we wouldn't have enough pure Dark-type Pokémon in existence to do a top 10.
Oh, because it's not like you've been doing this throughout the entire fucking list. What exactly are Lightbulb, Mighty Ena, and Zoroark to you then? Oh, we have to put them on the list too, because if we counted them as evolutions, you wouldn't have enough pure Dark-type Pokémon in existence to do a top 10. You understand, don't you?
No! Fuck that!
That is the stupidest bullshit you have pulled out of your ass so far. There is absolutely no reason to count Pokemon that have evolutionary lines as singular Pokemon. But counting Mega Absol is especially stupid, because it is literally just Absol with better stats. And now we have no reason to watch the rest of this segment because not only is it a huge ass fucking cop-out, but it is literally filler. Again.
But the number one best Dark-type Pokémon in existence is the only pure Dark-type Pokémon that we have yet to examine. And of course, that is Darkrai.
Because powerful legendary, that's literally all you need now. Do I really need to go over why including a legendary in a list where a majority of the choices were regular Pokémon, and the fact that said choices were limited on top of that, is just a retarded move? If you say yes, I will fucking shank you with a clef key. After Darkrai gets his nice little blowjob, it's the usual end of video shit, so let me give my final thoughts. Okay, so this list isn't necessarily the worst out there, but it's still not great. A huge majority of the segments on this list were not in-depth and were literally less than 40 seconds long. Like, I can understand that a chair is a chair and there's not a lot you can do about that, but you're gonna need to explain why these mons are better than one another in some way. And the criteria for this list was just plain random and had no real logic to it at all. In fact, the decision to just opt out all the dual-type mons in general was just stupid from the word go. You legitimately have 5 Pokemon to work with from that rule. I don't know what justification there could be to that rule, but it better be good. Interpolating my rule on placing Pokemon that have darkest to primary typing back into play, you can get another 9 options for the list. And that number does happen to account for evolutionary lines and opts out the legendaries. I guess the main thing I can say about this list is, basically, try not to limit yourself heavily. Don't make a best of Pokemon list with just focusing on a single mon, and then just include its evolution after. It just seems redundant. And please explain why exactly these guys would be on the list, and tell me what makes them special or better than others. Consistently. I appreciate you watching this lovely train wreck with me, everybody. Leave a nice little comment down below. What can I improve on? Other things I'm not taking into account, yada yada, all that bullshit. With that said, I'm just gonna sign off for now. Have a nice day.